to discuss communication related to GIT cases. I will enumerate the most common cases first. We discussed in the last meeting esophagus, the perforation of esophagus. Also, we can meet and encounter in the exam esophageal varices and the patient need urgent endoscopy and injection of esophageal varices. It is this is a common scenario also. And also, there is a common scenario than one patient admitted with bleeding esophageal varices and after endoscopy and injection of the varices, the patient died after 30 minutes. It's one of scenario. Then, if we went for, if we are going to discuss gastric in the communication scale, we can meet that patient with epigastric pain and for diagnostic upper endoscopy, or patient with diagnostic upper endoscopy and refilled gastric cancer. For duodenum, patient with recurrent attack of gastrointestinal manifestations in the form of diarrhea and the need upper endoscopy for jejunal biopsy to confirm the diagnosis of celiac disease, or the patient already biopsy has been done and you are your task to explain the result of celiac disease biopsy that revealed this patient has celiac disease. Other cases related to the liver, new diagnosis hepatitis C virus, or patient candidate for liver biopsy, or obstructive jaundice due to malignancy. For the bowel, we have to explain ulcerative colitis. We have three scenarios in ulcerative colitis. First, new diagnosis of ulcerative colitis. Second one, patient not responding to the treatment and you are going to admit him for intravenous corticosteroid and blood transfusion. Third one patient with ulcerative colitis, severe ulcerative colitis, and there is there is bank colitis in colonoscopy, and you your consultant inform you to this patient is candid for total colectomy. The other thing to explain the Crohn's disease. Patient has Crohn's disease. Your task to explain to him the Crohn's. Then cancer colon in the large bowel. So either localized or metastatic cancer colon. If we are going to the kidney, the most common cases in the exam in the kidney, renal biopsy. Patient with adult polycystic kidney disease. And the patient is candid for nephrostomy because this patient has obstructive urology. This the most common cases in gastrointestinal system that encounter in the exam. Actually, if you want to go all these cases, I have the scenarios for these cases. If we want to discuss all, we can discuss them. If we want to only to discuss every ethical issue, like we can explain the procedure, no, we will take one case, explain the new diagnosis, we can take one case, explain breaking bad news, we will can do one case. What is your suggestion, to do every cases or only give an example for each ethical issue or it's a medical issue?
I think the example is enough, Dr. Ahmad.
Okay. First, we will do it after that in the beach. We can do it in the beach. Okay. we will do the first case. Patient hepatitis C virus.
عبد الرحمن.
تفضل يا فندم. Male patient, 43 years old. He attended to the clinic because he told by his female partner she had hepatitis C virus. And she was admitted to the hospital with abdominal pain and deterioration in the liver function. He is worried because he may be got hepatitis C virus from here. Hepatitis C virus antibody has been done for him and the result released today and he has positive hepatitis C. Your task to explain to him the diagnosis and the prognosis of his case. Also, you have to counsel him against other virus could be transmitted through sexual intercourse. كده دكتور عمرو.
كده طبعا كده
اتفضل.
مورنينج يا مستر احمد.
جود مورنينج يا دكتور.
انا دكتور عمرو ميسي مستر اوف ميديكال اكلينيك توداي. نايس تو ميت يو.
نايس تو ميت يو تو.
Mr. Ahmad, I am here today to discuss some issues regarding your medical problem. That's suitable time for you now?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, Mr. Ahmad. Mr. Ahmad, how do you feel now?
I don't have any complaint, doctor. I just worried about I could catch hepatitis B virus from my partner. She told me that she has hepatitis C virus. And in the last 4 days, she has been admitted to the hospital, and we noticed that there is abnormal liver function test. And in the last visit, the consultant requested for me hepatitis C virus to detect if it is present in the blood or no. I am here today. I want to know the result of this blood test.
Okay. First of all, do you want anybody to attend our meeting, like your partner?
No.
Okay. So, Mr. Ahmad, actually, the result was released today.
But first I would ask you, what is your expectation about this investigation?
I searched,
You all of our team?
I searched a lot, doctor, in the website, and I found that there is a high percentage of hepatitis C virus could be transmitted through intimate relationships.
Okay, that's good, Mr. Ahmed. Actually, Mr. Ahmed, the result was released today, and I am afraid to tell you that the result is not as we hope.
You mean, doctor, I have hepatitis C virus?
I am sorry to tell you, Mr. Ahmed, the result released that you have positive hepatitis C virus. I am sorry to tell you about this bad news today.
It is, is it confirmed, doctor?
Actually, we did this blood test, which believes that there is some protein present in the blood, and this protein called antibodies. And this antibodies mean that you have hepatitis C virus was confirmed. What do you think about this, Mr. Rahman?
Yes, doctor. That is could be also not present in the blood.
Again, hello.
Do you mean that, doctor? It could be not in the blood also, the hepatitis C virus.
Actually, this hepatitis C virus is present in the blood and it can affect also the liver. But we confirm now that this protein is present in the blood and means this virus is present now in your system.
Yes, doctor.
So how much you know, Mr. Ahmed, about this hepatitis C virus?
I just know that from the leaflet that given by me by the consultant last meeting, the virus affects the liver and could be affect the functions of the function of liver.
Yes, that's true, Mr. Ahmed. Would you like me to explain to you more about this condition, Mr. Ahmed?
Sure, doctor.
Okay, if you allow me, Mr. Ahmed, you know, this is in our body, liver function, store glucose, which is responsible for our energy. It's responsible also to get rid of our metabolites of the body and to process medicines and the like, alcohol also, and they also responsible to make the material quantified, which is responsible for absorption of food particles. Sometimes there is cause inflammation of the liver. One of this factor is called viruses, which can attack the liver, and one of these viruses is called hepatitis C virus. So it can cause inflammation of the liver. Are you following me, Mr. Ahmed?
Yes, Dr. I'm you.
Okay. So what's happening is that this virus is present in the bloodstream and affects mainly the liver. And this virus can be transmitted by a lot of methods. The most important of them is bloodborne virus can be transmitted mainly through like blood transfusion. For example, if you are sharing needles or infected syringe, for example, then a lot of causes can be transmitted with virus.
Yes, doctor. Is there any treatment for this virus? And what is it going to do for me now?
Actually, Mr. Ahmed, there is treatment for this virus, but first of all, we have to do some investigation. Exactly because this virus has a lot of types, so we have to do some specific test to know the type of your virus. According to type, there is medicine can be given. One of them be given on the skin every 1 week, and other medicine can be taken orally. But this will be according to the type of your virus. Of course, there's some types who can respond well to the medicine, other is not responding to the virus. But it's too early to talk about this now, Mr. Rahman.
Yes, doctor.
was also this virus can present, you can clear the virus from your system, which is for the first 6 months, there is the possibility that you can clear the virus for yourself, but it persists for more than 6 months. It means that you have the virus for a long time, and it will be a chronic condition, a long-standing condition, which may affect the liver in the future.
So, doctor, now you mean that you will do blood test for me to confirm if I need treatment or not?
We will first what's called the PCR test can detect the viral load in your body, and also you may need to take a sniff from your liver to detect if there is any steering of your liver or no, because this will determine the need for and the particular treatment. And so this will be discussed by my consultant.
Yes, doctor. What is the percentage of to be cured from the virus without treatment?
Actually, Mr. Ahmed, I don't know exactly what the percent. I may ask my senior colleague. But in general, there is a possibility 1 in 5 can clear the virus by his own, and there is percent 4 or 5 can persist the virus and cause the chronic hepatitis C virus.
Yes, doctor. For the treatment modalities, doctor, is there any cure from the treatment modalities? If I receive medication after that, what is the percentage for response to the medication?
The percentage, Mr. Ahmed, told you from 5 to 5. Because there is a lot of on this side. There is sites which can respond well to the medicine, and others there is a poor response to the medicine. According to your type, we'll know what is the percentage of this, the percentage of successful rate of medicine.
Here, there is doctor. But you told me it could be injection per week, 1 week. Is there an oral treatment available for this virus?
As I told you, Mr. Ahmed, there's two medicines can be given. One of them via under the skin and once per week, and the other medicine is given orally in combination with the other one for around 1 year. And you know this hepatitis C virus is one of the new era of medicine, and there is developing the drugs in the future maybe, but currently this is the only treatment available now.
Yes, doctor.
Maybe future new medicines for this problem.
Okay, doctor.
So Mr. Ahmed, can I ask you some private questions, if you don't mind?
Sure, doctor, yes.
Do you have any history of sharing needles?
No.
You have unprotected sex with your partner?
No.
Hello?
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 Hey, I'm not.
Okay. Are you smoking, Mr. Ahmed?
No.
Are you taking alcohol?
No.
Okay. This is a good thing, Mr. Ahmed, because you know alcohol is one of the factors that take the liver off. So it's why alcohol is almost taking alcohol. Could you open your stomach? And how do we improve the thing?
Could you repeat that, please, again, doctor?
With whom you are getting, Mr. Ahmed? And what you are doing for living?
I am a teacher and I live with my partner and my daughter.
Okay. So it is why your partner already diagnosed with that's right?
Yes, doctor.
Okay. So one of the other important things, Rahmat, that you have those screening for other viruses that could be transmitted through the blood. One of them is called the hepatitis B virus. It can also be transmitted in the same way. And the one virus also called hepatitis HIV.
ايه دكتور؟
virus is important because this virus can be transmitted in the same way. And also twice to inform your partner about this because also she had to do this investigation to screen for other blood-borne viruses like hepatitis C and hepatitis HIV.
Is this also blood test?
This also hepatitis C virus and also HIV, but regarding HIV, there is concern you have trained before doing the test.
Okay.
What do you think about this, Mr. Rahman?
Yes, doctor, no problem for that.
Okay. And also it is wise to be take care of using the toothbrush and the rather not to be contaminated with other and also to have a proper time. Are you following me, Mr. Rahman? No?
Yes, doctor, I am with you.
Okay. So what's your concern till now, Mr. Ahmed? Do you have any other concern or any question you want me to ask?
Yes, doctor. You have 2 minutes remaining. Doctor, now you told me this blood could be transmitted through blood. I'm afraid, I worried, doctor, about my daughter. She has now 2 years. It could be she got the virus from her mother.
Actually, Mr. Ahmed, it's a good question because sometimes the virus can be transmitted during delivery, during birth. So it is better to do screening also for your daughter to be sure that she had this virus. That's why it's to do this.
Okay.
Okay. You have any other concern? Rahman?
No, doctor, thank you.
So, can you let me summarize for you, Mr. Ahmed, what we did in our discussion today?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, so, Mr. Ahmed, today you are here today to discuss the results of blood tests which reveals that you have hepatitis C virus. And as I told you, virus affecting the heart and sometimes being born and sometimes persist for a long time and cause some problems in the liver, like the scaling and the liver swelling for the future. And what we do is that there is some medicine can be given, but according to the type of your virus. And also we have to do some other HIV, and also it is wise to do screening for your daughter. So can you tell me more, Mr. Ahmed, what you get in our discussion?
Yes, doctor. I understood that I have hepatitis C virus, and you run some investigation to decide the plan of management, and do you run also some investigation to confirm if my daughter got this virus from her mother or not? And do you
okay.
refer
also
me
I will give you
for
my phone.
Some blood tests to do for hepatitis B virus and other virus called HIV?
Okay. Also, I will give you my contact number, Ahmed, and some website you can read more about this condition. And if you have any question, you can call me at any time.
Okay, doctor.
Do you want anyone to accompany you?
No, thank you. Could you tell us about the ethical issue in the scenario?
Ethical issue in the scenario, first one is autonomy. The patient should have about his condition. Second issue is the patient and the model, patient and the model, patient aim to do good and not do harm for the patient and to inform him about his condition and possibility of treatment. The third one is justice.
Yes. What about this patient, about the risk of being cured? You told us it could be 1 out of 5. What is the total cure for response to treatment?
Percent for cure of treatment according to the genotype. In the first three genotype, one or two or three, the person around 40 to 50.
Okay.
40 to 50 to be cured. Sorry, 40 to 50, not to be. Remember.
Yes. What about this this patient now? He has hepatitis C virus. Could you this affect his life after that? Social activity or his life insurance company?
Yes, I should inform him that may affect his insurance in the future.
What do you mean that is any patient candidate for treatment for hepatitis B, you have to do for him liver biopsy?
Not the one is other possibility like fibro scan. But this can be decided by the consultant, gastroenterology consultant, who will decide whether to do or not.
Yes, for it is not okay. We'll discuss that later. What about the new treatment for hepatitis C virus?
I don't know what form interferon and the ribavirin.
Yes. اوكي
لسه طالع من مين ده؟
من from one week.
One week.
But this is only for genotype 2 and 4. For genotype 2 and 3. For genotype 4, we have to do for give the patient also interferon. For discussion about HIV. ايوه فندم. هذا اوكي اتس جاست ا ديسكشن وي ريبيتد ات اجين فور اتش اي في ذيس بيشنت هاز هيباتيتس سي فيروس ناو ان يور بلان اوف مانجمنت دو يو وونت تو جيف هيم سمثينج لايك اذر فاكسينيشن؟
يس يس كان جيف هيم فاكسينيشن اجينست هيباتيتس سي فيروس
and hepatitis A also, if he is negative for hepatitis A.
And
the body is yes. What's about his social, sorry, his intimate relationship? Did you inform him that he has to do safe intimate relationship?
Yes, I informed him.
To do in the future?
I told him to do safe sex in the future.
Okay. هنا كومنت
يس دكتور احمد if you allow me
يس دكتور صالح
he has to inform the GP also about his diagnosis that GP will take into consideration that if he has any illness maybe related to his condition he has to tell also the any hospital or any medical care he is seeking for the medical staff to take consideration also regarding his condition and regarding also the plan of management. I think there is some defect in the plan of management, the plan of management and the complication also of hepatitis C. The plan of management maybe he will tell him that they will assess his condition. If his condition, if he fulfilled the criteria of a specific treatment, which is combination treatment in the form of interferon alpha and ribavirin, and this treatment can be curable in 50% of the cases, but unfortunately 50% of the cases also had relapse of hepatitis C, and also complication of hepatitis C, that he may got varices or dilated blood conduits in his food pipes and may in the future develop vomiting out blood, and he may need periodic endoscopy to assess his blood conduits in the food pipes.
Okay.
That's all from me.
any other comment?
Also, Switzerland, that about hepatitis, we have to be screened for hepatitis.
Yes, Dr. Sade.
Yes. He has to be screened for hepatitis B and HIV also, because it is one of the ones of the blood transmitted diseases also.
Okay. دكتور حسن يس يس
هو تكملة بس للكلام اللي قاله دكتور صادق هو ريسبكت اوف الورك بس انا عايز اضيف حاجه واحده ان كان مفترض ان انا اساله في حاله كوميونيكيشن كان عنده باي بولر ديس اوردر ولا لا خصوصا ان الانترفيرون بيأفكت بيعمل لي ديبريشن وبيأفكت المنتاليتي وبيعمل سيكوز اذا كان العيان بريدكتبل فور ذيس دي حاجه ثاني حاجه من ضمن الحاجات اللي عملها له ان انا اعمل له ريجولار فولو اب عن طريق السي بي سي ان انا ايه أنا لازم اقول له ان الانترفيرون بيأفكت البون مارو وبالتالي بيأفكت الكومبوننت اوف ذا بلاد سو يو نيد تو بي ريجوليتد تو بي ريجولار تشيك اب باي ريجولار
اوكي ان اذر كومنت اوكي اول اوف اس اتفضلوا بسرعه
يعني اي ثينك اللاست فيو كومنتس ويل ميك ذا كونديشن فروم كوميونيكيشن تو كونسلنج بيشنت اباوت تريتمنت
Yes,
I think the scenario is breaking bad news, not counseling about treatment.
Yes, that's I'm going to tell that. First, we all of us forget that there is a role for consultant to run some investigation for him. But at the start, multiple scenario meeting is very important for this patient, and you will refer for him for for liver physician. And the liver physician will run some investigation to confirm the diagnosis and to confirm the type of hepatitis C virus. And according to this result, we will consider the treatment for him. The treatment in the form of injection and tablet, and there is new treatment for could be oral treatment. And there is some side effect for the treatment, like you can feel fatigue or flu symptoms, and the consultant will counseling you about this adverse effect of medication in after confirming that you are candidate for treatment. We can inform him just like this, not more detailed. For non-pharmacological management, be sure that we have to do for this patient vaccination. And we have also to inform him to be away from some drugs and alcohol that could be deteriorating his liver condition. And we have to inform him about insurance company and about the importance of other blood-borne diseases. And the liver biopsy is not as the guidelines in the hepatitis C virus diagnosis or diagnosis in fibrosis. Just ordering. But to go in detail for medical treatment and explain everything about the medical treatment, it will be, you will not finish because we have two tasks. One task to inform hepatitis C virus and what is the future plan of care, and other tasks to counseling the patient about HIV and hepatitis B. Actually, Dr. Rami, he gave us a hint, only small hint, about HIV and hepatitis B. He take about 1 minute to explain to the patient. It is part from the task. You have to take a lot of time, at least 5 minutes in the scenario, to explain to him what is hepatitis HIV and the HIV could be positive and could be negative, just a few minutes, not to mention that in the last minute. Confidentiality is very important, but we have to inform other health authority about his condition, because now he is at risk and could be transmitted this virus to other doctor if he didn't inform them. So that inform GP is very important. If he is going to do any procedure, he has to inform the health physician or the team looking after him. Any ethical issue, we have four ethical issues. Autonomy, in this patient, the patient has the right to refuse or accept the medical treatment. And has the right also to do further investigation or not. Number two, do the best thing for the patient. This patient has the right to inform him about the medical problem and what the complications could be having from hepatitis C virus. Avoid harm for the patient. we don't have the right to give the patient medication that would be deteriorate his condition. Just as this patient should be take a medication for hepatitis C virus without any discrimination according to his age or according to his nationality.
الكونفيدنشاليتي يا دكتور احمد برضه فيري امبورتنت ان ذيس كيس.
كونفيدنشاليتي يس وي انفورم ناو فيري امبورتنت بس وي هاف تو انفورم هيم تو انفورم اذر هيلث تيم لوكينج افتر هيم از يو سيد جي بي اند اف هي از جوينج تو دو ا بروسيدور هي هاز تو انفورم ذيم اباوت هيز كارنت ستيتس فور هيباتيتس سي.
And to assure him that you are the only one to know the result. And the result will not be released in letter or email, and we will inform anyone if you want to him to know.
Yes, yes, that's it.
هذا
yes. الدكتور. معلش بس لو
تقول لنا انت الكونسلنج عن ال HIV كده في
كلمتين. احنا هنعمل حالة HIV يعني. ما انت تعملها
لنا قبل ما نشتغل.
نعم.
تقول لنا عليها قبل ما نشتغل.
ان شاء الله. So that Dr. Ram, he explained a lot about what hepatitis C virus. We have to organize ourselves to just note hepatitis C virus. What is the plan of management? What is the complication could be having and the treatment? Also, Dr. Ram, forget that he give everything to the patient before he told him, I will refer you for the liver physician. يعني you are not one man show. You part of the team for health organization.
بالنسبة للترانسميشن of hepatitis C يا دكتور أحمد because of sexual transmitted disease is it controversial?
Yes, it is. You can say for that it is less than 60%. 60% sorry, it is less than 60%. Anyway, this confirms there is a risk for hepatitis C during the sexual transmission, during sexual act, at least than 6%. Some told 3, some told 4, some told 2, but the recommended number in the British gastroenterology that this patient less than 60%. And for delivery from mother, it less than 5%.
It could also that Dr. Ron checked the risk factors for transmission of hepatitis C.
He already, we know that from where he got hepatitis C virus.
Mm-hmm.
And he got for hepatitis C from his partner.
طب هي
هيبقى
شكلها
ايه
هي
هي هي هي هي هي هي هي هي hepatitis C and she admitted to the hospital with abnormal function, abnormal liver function test.
No, he's known to have hepatitis C, no need to for safe intimate relationship.
Yeah, this is a good question. I forget to ask. We have six types of hepatitis C virus. Okay. The patient could be take two types, two genotypes. Okay, and it could be his wife, she has hepatitis C virus, genotype 2, and he has genotype 4. So that he had to do with her safe intimate relationship. But hepatitis B virus, if both have hepatitis B, no need to do for them safe intimate relationship.
Or maybe he will have the relationship with others.
Yes. Okay, this hepatitis C virus is frequent in the exam, and just to highlight about that, maybe one of the concern of the patient, he doesn't like injection and he need oral medication only. Now confirmed oral medication only for genotype 2 and 4 and 3. And
طب بالنسبة للعلاج الجديد بتاع الهباتيتس سي يا دكتور احمد اللي كان بيقولوا عليه السنة دي الجديد ده نذكره ولا ما نذكروش؟
ده هيباتيتس سي مش لامفيدوين ما هوش لامفيدوين فور تريتمنت انا ايم سبيكينج ناو اباوت نيو تريتمنت فور هيباتيتس سي ذير از ا نيو تريتمنت فور هيباتيتس سي فور جينوتايب اند 4 2 اند 3 سوري اباوت جينوتايب 4 ذا بيشنت شود ريسيف اولسو انترفيرون besides this oral new oral medication. So that there is a new treatment for hepatitis C virus in the form of oral for some specific gene only, not for all genotype.
What about the newest treatment, FDA, lower semibrivir, just released recently?
Yes, we can inform him. Yes. It is recommended by FDA 5 days ago. It released a long time, and it's recommended by FDA 5 days ago. It is now for genotype 2 and 3. And also for genotype 4. But in genotype 4, we will add interferon. So that the percentage for success with interferon, it reach about 95%. The old regimen has an interferon and ribavirin, 75% success of treatment.
But very
expensive. Very, very expensive.
$28,000
per course.
Of course.
يعني around 84,000 Egyptian pound.
ده أكتر من كده يا كرحمة. يا عبد الرحمن أنت بتغير على الدولار بكام؟ 5 جنيه ولا إيه؟
أكتر من كده. اللي فرق اللي ريسبونس يا دكتور فتح الله يعني ممكن يبقى اللي فرق ريسبونس أكتر 3 مانس.
30,000 دولار يعني أنت بتتكلم في 220,000 جنيه.
3000 فرقة خلاص. From 70% to 90-95%.
لكن جين تاب 1 و 3 هي كان تيك اورال اونلي.
هي كان تيك اورال اونلي اه. But 4 should be still should be received interferon. تفضل دكتور حسين.
As regards the question of are you sure, what is the response?
Yes, we as Dr. Rami said, we have now antibody and we will run some blood test to confirm that it is called PCR to know the number of the virus in the blood and decide the management plan. There is a debate in this issue, but I would say to you, but you have to not to mention that in the for examiner because there is a debate. It is only one study done in Spain about this the patient relation between hepatitis C virus and the body and the PCR, and they found that some patients with hepatitis C virus antibody and the negative PCR. It's only one study done for this.
So I have to confirm it with PCR.
I thought
the recommendation is this screening with HCV if it is positive in a high risk group like this patient. There is no need to confirm.
No. We have to confirm if this patient has hepatitis C virus antibody and especially there is a cure rate for 20% from acute hepatitis to be to not chronic hepatitis. And I mean this patient could have hepatitis now. And he got hepatitis because his partner 4 years ago she has hepatitis C virus. Maybe he got before and now only he cured.
Yes.
And also but PCR here it's for treatment. And if we found the PCR normal and there is a normal liver enzyme, we couldn't start a treatment for him. تفضل.
A second, two more questions. A rule of liver biopsy, would I offer him a liver biopsy? Or?
No, it is not in the guidelines.
Okay. Sir, the one, accidentally discovered it. Will we start the treatment immediately or shall we wait?
Shall we wait? To confirm that if it's PCR or no. If positive PCR, will start.
I mean, even if the PCR is positive, he will start the treatment immediately, or he will give him a 12 weeks of
no,
spontaneous.
We have to start because you don't know when he got that. He has long contact with his partner for 4 years. Maybe he got early. And also,
I just came to my mind because I just ran, so it's up to date. It looks like they are mentioning the patient can be given 12 weeks of. Of a trial of spontaneous recovery before starting the treatment. even from the time of diagnosis, you know, though the time of transmission is not known. I'm not sure of that, maybe.
In the guidelines, even now, they are giving for acute hepatitis, there's 100% cure rate if you start treatment for acute hepatitis C. This 100% for response to treatment.
So under normal liver enzymes, so it's not
I didn't tell you now he is acute. Sorry, I didn't tell you now normal liver enzyme. I am telling you, if we run some investigation and we found that liver enzyme is normal and the BCR is low, this patient is not candidate for treatment.
Okay.
But if you have now, patient elevated liver enzyme and BCR is high, you have to start the treatment. You have to, don't wait for 12 months for you to be cured.
دكتور احمد as regard waiting 12 weeks for spontaneous remission, this is just mentioned in the cases of the incidental bin break in the hospitals. When you have an incidental discovery of hepatitis C after bin break in the hospital, there is a chance for spontaneous remission after within 12 weeks. You can give them the patient 12 weeks period just to try to a spontaneous remission. But in case that the patient discovered to have hepatitis C after his wife, this is another scenario. This is another condition. Yani. There is no waiting for 12 weeks to treat.
Yes, you are right. And also I emphasize about there is treatment for acute hepatitis C virus. Acute hepatitis C virus, shooting liver enzyme, high BCR, we can start the treatment. But in the case of nidalistic injury and normal liver enzyme and the BCR is low and or negative, we can wait for 12 weeks, as you said, Dr. Ashraf.
معلش
ثانية
يا دكتور أحمد
الحتة دي. Any patient, you know that the time of infection, you have to assess if this patient is candidate for treatment or not. If the indication for treatment, shooting liver enzyme and high BCR in acute hepatitis C virus, we can start the treatment for him. Or we will wait for 12 weeks to be sure that this patient is cured or not cured. If his condition is stable and his liver function is normal.
يعني في الأكيوت لأن one in four patients the immunity can clear the virus.
هل الأكيوت؟ لا not in acute, in chronic.
يعني في needle stick injury, لو واحد جالب needle stick injury دلوقتي وشك في عيان كان عنده hepatitis C virus. عمله الهيباتيتس سي فايروس ار ان اي وعمله البي سي ار ليفر انزايم كده.
ايوه
الو.
ايوه دكتور محمد.
دكتور احمد.
ايوه يا فندم سامعك.
لو هو بوزيتيف هل ابدا له تريتمنت ولا انتظر لما اشوفه هل هو هيتحول لكرونيك ولا لا؟
ايه اللي بوزيتيف يعني الليفر انزايم هاي وهاي بي سي ار؟ We can start the treatment for acute hepatitis.
For acute hepatitis.
Yes. If we looked for the what Dr. Hussein said now, also there is no clear answer for the question. And he wrote that down in the chat box. We can wait, and if the patient doesn't like to wait, we can start the treatment. Okay, and he doesn't give us clear answer about that.
That's my point of Prof. Dr. Ahmed, what to do, يعني how to tackle the question smoothly and not to give a clear answer. I don't know even the background of the examiner, so I don't know يعني إن أنا to go into the mud and ask what his background. I don't know want to do this. I just want to give a diplomatic answer and go away from that as rapid as possible.
Yes, you can give a diplomatic answer and inform him. I will refer you for liver physician, and he will decide if you are candidate for the treatment or not candidate. and it will be according to the result of the blood test and full stop. That's the diplomatic
that's
answer. Okay.
Yes, that's great.
Ah, yes.
That's great.
But if you are going to inform, this is the guidelines. Why I'm speaking now, that is the guideline for treatment for hepatitis C virus. Acute hepatitis C virus treatment indicated of shouting liver enzyme and high BCR, we can give treatment, and there's high cure rate with treatment of acute hepatitis B. For chronic, as Dr. Rami said, now the percentage for 75% for success with interferon and ribavirin. For start the treatment or not start the treatment, refer that for to consultant. Because if you see that, I will post the guidelines for treatment for hepatitis C virus, for acute and for chronic, and what is the bridge guideline. I will post it in the post for anyone if he is want to know in details about the treatment for whom and when. And
the guidelines like I see, Dr. Ahmed, guidelines of SCV is, يعني حد بيقراها ما بيطلعش حاجة منها.
لا أنا حديك الهنت بوينت اللي
اتجاوبت. بالله عليك يعني.
أنا مش هبوظ الجايدلاينز عارف.
حاجة فظيعة يعني واحد قراها مرتين ومش فارقة في حاجة، كل مرة مرتين لكني ما فهمتش فيها حاجة.
أنا هديك الكلير أنسر يعني هم ثلاث أنسر هديهم لك. When to start treatment, for whom you have to start treatment, and when you have to stop treatment. This is the three answers for hepatitis C virus. يعني who is the patient is candid, and what is the type of drug, and for how long. That's it.
ويتك يا دكتور احمد ان شاء الله.
ماشي.
عادة يا دكتور احمد بس معلش في الحالة دي احنا قلنا الليفر بايوبسي بعد البي سي ار ممكن ما يكونش ليها انتيشن، انا ممكن اذكرها له ولا ما اذكرهاش
انتيشن؟ ما تجيبش ليفر بايوبسي خالص يا دكتور محمد، يعني مش مكتوبه ليفر بايوبسي دلوقتي بقت استخدامها فيري ريل جدا فور انكسبليند اليفيتد ليفر انزايم. يعني او يو هاف تو يعني اند ذير از ا لوت اوف انفستيجيشن ناو. يس you have a lot of investigation you can do it to diagnose if this patient has fibrosis or not fibrosis. We have fibro scan, we have also there is a test, fibro test, and it is some the blood test would be done to know that if this patient has fibrosis or not. Okay, let's go to the next case.
ازيك يا دكتور هشام؟
ازيك يا دكتور احمد؟
ايه الاخبار؟ كويس؟
الحمد لله تمام والله.
دكتور شلبي لسه مش مقتنع بالورفارين في السكند ترينستر؟
والله الموضوع ده عامل لنا قلق جامد قوي.
ده يا عم ده دوكيومنت بقاله سنه ونص. لا
انا مكتوبه في اخر جايد لاين ديت. انا كتير يعني
كانت في 2011؟
ايوه لا انا كتير جدا يعني. من الاسبوع ال 12 ممكن تبدا تصيفلي لحد قبل البريجنس بشهر ولا حاجه.
انت بتقول يا دكتور هشام مكتوبه في انهي جايد لاينز؟
اظن انا في حاجه اسمها الثوراسيك امريكان ثوراسيك جايد لاين مكتوبه في البي اي في الدورنج بريجنسي كاتبين حته يعني هي البي اي البي اي البي اي جايد لاين حاطين في الاخر ان بريجنسي قالوا ان هي كان بي يوزد من الاسبوع ال 12 حد الميد اوف سير ترامستر يعني حد نص السير ترامستر.
انت لو انا حتى خدت كوبي بيست منها من بيشنت دوت يو كي دوت كو خدت كوبي من الانديكيشن فور وارفرين الكونترا انديكيشن فور وارفرين مكتوب الكونترا انديكيشن بتاعت الوارفرين في الفيرست والثير ترامستر اوف بريجنسي.
تمام
انا حتى حطيتها في الكومنت على الكومنت للدكتور محمد.
تمام خلاص اقتنعنا بيها
اصلا. الحمد لله. لا عشان اصلا ده معانا سورس يو كي يعني مش امريكان بس.
تمام.
السلام عليكم.
السلام عليكم. الحمد لله.
دكتور عبد الله. السلام عليكم. السلام عليكم.
السلام. ماشي يا دكتور هشام اتفضل. مسز امل 28 years old. She was attended to the clinic because she is worried about hepatitis B virus. Her husband was diagnosed hepatitis B virus 2 weeks ago, and some medication was started for him, and she is pregnant. Her concern, she asked about the hepatitis B.
Okay.
Your task to explain to her the management plan of her condition.
Okay.
اتفضل.
Good morning Mrs. Amal.
Good morning Doctor.
أنا دكتور هشام عبد الواحد السينيور هاوس اوفيسر ان ميسن كلينك توداي. نايس تو ميت يو.
نايس تو ميت يو تو.
Mrs. Amal, I got some data I want to confirm with you. Are you Mrs. Amal 28 years old?
Yeah, Doctor.
Okay, Ms. Amal, we are here today to discuss your concern about the hepatitis B virus. Is it okay with you?
Okay, doctor, yeah.
Okay, Ms. Amal. As a part, I'm sorry about the bad news about your husband. As I informed, he has diagnosed as hepatitis B 2 weeks back.
Yes, doctor, he was diagnosed with hepatitis B virus. And he told me that the consultant informed him he should inform his partner.
Yeah.
And he told me I should, I have to follow up with a specialist because there's a risk for transmission of hepatitis B.
Yeah, he's right, Mrs. Amal. Okay, Mrs. Amal, you have children?
Yes, doctor. I have one kid.
One kid. And you are pregnant, as I have been informed, right?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, Mrs. Amal. So, Mrs. Amal, do you have any symptoms right now?
No.
And your kid is okay and no complaining from anything?
No.
Okay, good. So, Amal, what do you know about hepatitis B virus?
When I informed by my husband about hepatitis B, I searched in the website and I read a lot. And I was frustrated when I heard that it could be transmitted through intimate relationship.
Yeah.
And there is a risk for transmission from hepatitis B. If I got hepatitis B from my husband, there is a high risk of transmission of hepatitis B to my kids. I saw what a doctor.
Yeah. Okay, Mrs. Amal, I explained to you some data about the hepatitis B. And if you find any more difficult, please stop me and ask me what, about screening.
Okay.
It's a virus infection, can affect your liver mainly, and as you read, it's transmitted through either blood, through blood transfusion, or through sharing a needle, or through a sharp object in contaminated by the virus, or the unprotected sexual intercourse or sexual contact with an infected person. Also can be transmitted from the mother to her baby during delivery. The virus هنا في the body is 80% of the people can clear the virus without any treatment by their immune system, and only 20% will continue to carry the virus. Carrying the virus doesn't mean to be symptomatic, maybe asymptomatic. May have some symptoms. Usually, a small number of the people, around 20%, will get in more inflammation of the liver and scarring of their liver, and in liver failure. And very small number, very very low risk, they may get cancer in their liver. And those people had very very poor outlook. Ms. Amal, do you want to know anything more about the virus?
My concern, doctor, about my baby and about me. I read that there is a high risk of transmission of hepatitis B through intimate relationship. And I want to know if I got hepatitis B or not. And what is the plan if I got this hepatitis B?
Okay, did you ever get a screening for hepatitis B before?
Recently, no.
Okay. Okay, so our plan, there is a risk the virus can be transmitted through sexual, from unprotected sexual intercourse with an infected person. Although it's low, but it can be happen, and as you are pregnant, routinely we have to check the immune status of the pregnant woman. So the plan, we have to check your immune status, and we have to check you again, check your virus status. We'll do for you some lab tests to find your status. If you are not have the virus, and you are not immune against the virus, we will start immune, give you immunization or vaccination. The vaccination is 3 injections given in 6 months period, and it can protect against the hepatitis B almost high protection, almost 90 to 95% can protect the people against the hepatitis B infection.
Is it safe, doctor?
No, nothing 100% safe, but the protection is high. It can reach 95%. The most important now, you have to get safe sex with your partner using condom, and you have to be very sure not to use sharp object for the other, like razors, like toothbrush. In case you are positive or carrying the virus, there is a different management plan. In this case, we have to check your liver status, and we'll refer you to the liver specialist, and there will be a special arrangement during delivery to protect your baby from transmitting the virus from you to him during delivery.
Yes, doctor. If I have the virus, doctor, there is any treatment available during a pregnancy? And how how can I save my baby?
This is a very good question, Mrs. Amal, and I thank you for asking me this question. Usually, there is no, most of the people will cure the virus or can control the virus by their immune system, and they didn't need treatment. But of course, this will be after the revision of their liver status. If there is affection of your liver, like liver enzymes is high, and your liver specialty, you need to start the treatment. This will start by antiviral treatment. At that time, we have to take the safety of this antivirus in the pregnancy. Of course, we will also take opinion of obstetrician about this issue. How to protect your baby? This is the most important. During delivery, the virus B can transmit it to your baby. So in the delivery room, we have to give your baby two drugs. One of them, the first dose of vaccination in one arm, and the another arm will give the immunoglobulin dose into the muscle.
For baby doctor, is it safe? It is better for cesarean section or for normal vaginal delivery?
In the hepatitis B, there is no difference between cesarean section and vaginal delivery in the transmission of the disease. In the other virus, maybe there is a difference. But for hepatitis B, there is no difference. And we will also take the opinion to confirm our information about this by the obstetrician. But the most important is the medication to be given in the delivery room for your baby immediately post delivery, to inject him by the first dose of vaccine and by what we call the immunoglobulin against hepatitis.
Yes, doctor.
Any other information you want to know? Any other question?
I want to know now when the result will be released.
After we take blood sample, almost a matter of days, we can give you the information back. I will give you another appointment after 3 days. After the result came back, then we can sit again. We can discuss the your immune state against hepatitis B and your hepatitis B virus state.
And if there is, if I have immunity for hepatitis B, nothing will be done?
If you are immune against hepatitis B, usually we check the number. If there is if the high number is present, usually more than 100 is the number. We don't need to do anything. Because if you get the virus, your immune system and is ready to control the virus at the same at once. If the number is low, we can give you what we call a booster dose. But if it's negative at all, we have to start use the vaccine immediately.
Okay, doctor. And this vaccine is safe, you told me.
Almost all the people is safe. There is a small number of people have some side effects, like flu-like symptoms, and some people may have some muscle weakness after taking it.
Okay.
Also about, if you want to ask about the breastfeeding is safe in hepatitis B, and you can breastfeed your baby without any risk of transmission of the virus. Also hugging, kissing, and the usual daily activity doesn't transmit the virus. Your child in home, he also needs to check his immune status, because he will live with his father who has a risk to transmit the disease.
Okay, doctor, I am ready now to do this investigation, and I will come after a couple of days to see the result.
Okay. So there will be a consent. You will sign it to do the test. I will give it to you. You will sign it at the end of the discussion. Last thing, if the test is positive, it may affect you some issues in your life, like insurance. Of course, the current insurance will not be affected, but maybe the future insurance may be difficult to get. The other thing I want to know, what do you do for life, Mrs. Anderson?
I'm a teacher, doctor.
Teacher, okay. So there is no, I think there is no restriction with the teacher. You can continue to work without any problem. Of course, your confidentiality is paramount. The test result will only reach it to you. We only have to, if it's positive, of course, your partner, you know, and your GP also may need to know, and the treating team only, they will know the result.
Okay.
Okay, Mrs. Amal, do you have any other question or any other concern?
Thank you, doctor.
Thank you. To recap, our plan is to do or to investigate your immune status and your hepatitis virus status, hepatitis virus B status. If your immune system is negative and hepatitis B negative, we'll start to immunize you against hepatitis B. And if you are positive, we'll refer you to a specialist doctor, liver specialist. And he will check your liver status, and he will decide to start the treatment or not. And when delivery will arrange, and if you are positive, for this special arrangement for baby to vaccinate him at once to prevent transmission of virus. So Mrs. Amal, can you please tell me what you get from this meeting?
I got that, doctor. I